Jacob. I am Sandra Schulte. Welcome back to our show. Today, we have a very, very interesting person whose name is Gary Russo. Gary has many hats. Mm-hmm. One of his hats is a hard hat. He does construction. Another hat that he has is that of poet, author. Another hat he has is that of author. And his writings remind me of poetry. The way I met Gary is interesting. You know how you'll talk about to various friends, and they'll tell you how they wander down the beach and how they love the sand and the surf, and they maybe they collected shells. Well, the way I came across Gary Russo was sort of kind of like that. There I was walking down Second Avenue. Now, you know how it's been recently. Construction dust, construction, the usual stores. And all of a sudden, out of nowhere, there was this wonderful sound. There was a songbird. And he was singing. And it was his lunch break. And he reminded me of Frank Sinatra. In fact, in retrospect, I found out that he's called the Second Avenue Frank Sinatra. So here I am, a person who has a talk show, and I'm face to face with another Frank Sinatra.
Oh, thank you. I'm humbled by that.
So I asked him for his card, and he gave me, in which afterwards, this book, Don't Die. It is a story of how he progressed from a confused, puzzled person who wanted to find himself, wasn't sure to find himself, who went through all kinds of, a maze of different ways to find himself. Eventually, he realized that the company he was working for was giving him a roadmap, a kind of a roadmap. And once he recognized the application of that roadmap to his life, all he needed to do was to find his will, the courage, the fortitude to go and do it. So I would like to start off with Gary Russo talking about this wonderful book, Don't Die, to explain to us what that means and how it's relevant to his life.
Well, it's Don't Die with Your Song Unsung. So, but
what
it's a series of book. Don't Die with Your Song Unsung.
Yes.
But it relates to anything that's bubbles up inside you that you love to do. Basically, you summed up very well, Sandy. It was a process. I'll go from the beginning.
Please.
I worked many, many years for a very successful company. And every morning we'd come in and we would talk about the day's work, and there'd be pictures all around us of what I worked predominantly on bridges, and there'd be pictures of how the bridge should look when we're done, and every day you had a goal. You had somewhere to move forward. But I did not apply that to my home life or my personal life. I would just come home and I was kind of just going through the motions. I didn't really have a plan. I was busy doing things, but I didn't have a focused plan.
Did you feel an emptiness?
Absolute emptiness. I bought the concept. I was a very successful middle class American, getting up very early in the morning, working on the weekends, the family, and building properties, and a workaholic, I would say, in some ways, but somebody else's dream, probably. You know, you could make a lot of money in real estate, so I went into real estate. You can make money doing this. What I really loved to do when I was a little kid was entertain. So I was turning 50, or I was just 50, and I was up in Massachusetts, away from my children. My marriage had dissolved into nothing. That was pretty much done, but just holding on to clear up the loose ends. And missing my children, I would come back to an empty hotel room. And I said, is this it? I worked hard my whole life, and you know, I was working, I was making money, but so in that hotel room, I said, you know what? I want to go back to what I really wanted to do, and I was singing. So I used the being away from the family. I would come back to the room, and I would download music. And I came back. I went to buy some equipment. I bought a little setup, and lo and behold, I come back to New York, and they send me to the Second Avenue subway. But now I had something. I was listening to music. I was on. I didn't know what to do with it. So I was on the Second Avenue subway project, which, as you said, we were making a lot of noise, a lot of dust. We were blowing things up. We were not very well received by the neighborhood. So about a month, 6 weeks into the project that I was there, I decided maybe at my lunch hour I would just start singing. I had this equipment now. I had some music, and I had the will. So I set up a little microphone and a little stand and with background tracks, and I started singing. The first person stopped and smiled, a genuine smile at me. And I say it all started with a smile, because that one smile made me feel great. And then before you know, there were a couple of smiles.
It verified your existence, what you were doing.
The power of a smile is just amazing. So so here I am. I'm in my construction outfit, and I'm just, I don't know where to put it, but I'm singing. And a gentleman came by, David Fisher, who became a friend after this whole thing, and he videotaped me, videotaped digital, and he said, do you mind if I put it on YouTube? And YouTube is a site, if nobody's familiar with it, where people share videos. And before you know it, the next day, there was 100,000 people had watched it, and it started to go through the YouTube universe. And I get a call from ABC, Good Morning America, and the Today Show. Would you come on their show? So I wake up, I'm getting all these calls, I call it synchronicity. From a dark, cold hotel room in Massachusetts, I dreamed to sing, and now all of a sudden people are asking me to sing on shows. They're asking me to sing for different events, and that all happened within a month. I got a call from the Knicks. I did a timeout for them. I did the actual New York City Marathon. Mm-hmm. I had the pleasure of singing again the New York, New York at the beginning of the marathon. So basically the book is just let you know, don't ever give up your dream, but you have to do something about it. You know, the law of
attraction. And by the way, I have to say, the way you write is poetry. It isn't poetry per se, but it's poetry.
Oh, thank you. There's a co-author, a success coach who who worked with me on it. I had the easy part. I just had to tell my story in my own words. But she structured the whole book to mm-hmm. make it a quick read. And, you know, you hear stories of people doing, you know, the universe opens up to them. But
yes.
Actually, I'm the poster child for it in certain ways. And, you know, I am the most grateful person. It started to reflect on everything. I held myself back. I blamed circumstances around me. You know, you can't have a full-time job and have a career. You can. You know, every stereotype situation that I believed and I trusted broke down for me. I realized you could do so many wonderful things. And then I was afraid my children, you know, taking me on the road, they enjoy it. You have to do what you love to do. And the people around you will understand and they'll support you. So.
Thank you very much, Gary. Now I would like to hear you sing.
Sure.
I would like you to give the audience some examples of what drew me to you on that day on Second Avenue.
Well, the funny thing was, I'll get...
Yes.
They call me the Second Avenue Sinatra. I love standards. Mm-hmm. So and I always wore hats. So that was one thing. So they... giving me the Sinatra title was a big shoes to fill. But I really love Bobby Darin. Bobby Darin was, if I was trying to sound like anybody, would have been Bobby Darin. But I am just amazed at all the attention for that. But I would love to sing for you. I also have some footage of the New York City Marathon back you know, what goes on behind the scenes and singing on the stage. With my girlfriend was there, Amy Russell, Amy Jane Russell. She's a very good singer. So, Amy has completed the package because I have someone to share all this with, which makes it a better
That's very important,
better,
to share.
It makes the trip also sweeter. You know, when you do something exciting, the first thing you do is you want to call somebody up. So to be sharing that with someone is wonderful. So I'd be honored to sing for you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come on, fly with me, let's take off in the blue. Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Come on, fly with me, let's take off in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, you'll just glide, starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near, you might hear angels cheer, 'cause we're together. Weather-wise, it's such a lovely day. You just say those words and we'll beat those birds down to Acapulco Bay. It is perfect for a flying honeymoon, them do say. Come on, fly with me, let's fly, let's fly. Pack up, let's fly away.
Fly away. Not bad for a guy who started on the corner.
I've got you under my skin. I've got you deep in the heart of me. So deep in my heart that you're really a part of me. I've got you under my skin. I tried so, not to give in. I said to myself, this affair, it never will go somewhere. But why should I try to resist when, baby, I know damn well that I've got you under my skin. I'd sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near. In spite of that warning voice, it comes in the night, it repeats, yells in my ear. Don't you know, you little fool, you never can win. Use your mentality, wake up to reality. And each time I do, just the thought of you makes me stop before I begin. 'Cause I've got you under my skin.
Too bad we couldn't have a whole orchestra behind us today. They don't write them like this anymore.
sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near. In spite of that warning voice, it comes in the night, it repeats, yells in my ear. Don't you know, you little fool, you never can win. Use your mentality, wake up to reality. And each time I do, just the thought of you makes me stop before I begin. 'Cause I've got you, and I like you. Ooh, I've got you so under my skin.
Yeah. This is for Amy Jane.
Out of the tree of life, I just picked me a plum. You came along and everything started to hum. Still, it's a real good bet, the best is yet to come. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't that be fine? You think you've seen the sun, but you ain't seen it shine. Wait till the warm-up's underway. Wait till I hold you near. Or wait till you see that sunshine place. Ain't nothing like it here. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't that be fine? The best is yet to come, come the day you're mine. Come the day you're mine. I'm gonna teach you to fly. You've only tasted the wine. We're gonna drain that cup dry. Wait till your charms are right for these arms to surround. You think you've flown before, but baby, you ain't left the ground. Wait till you're locked in my embrace. Wait till I hold you near. Wait till you see that sunshine place. Ain't nothing like it here. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't that be fine? The best is yet to come, come the day you're mine. Come the day you're mine, and you're gonna be mine.
Hey, Sandy, come over here.
This next song, I'm gonna dedicate it to you because you've seen me sing this song on the streets. This is the song that was on YouTube, and you could, if you Google Gary Russo, this song comes up, and it's very special to me. So, this is to you, Sandy. Thanks for having me on the show.
The summer wind came blowing in from across the sea. It lingered there to touch your hair. Said, walk with me. All summer long, I sang some songs, and then we strolled that golden sand. Two sweethearts and the summer wind. Like painted kites, those days and nights, they went flying by. The world was new beneath that blue umbrella sky. And softer than a piper meant, one day it called to you. I lost you, I lost you to the summer wind. The autumn winds and the winter winds, they have come and gone. And still the days, those lonely days, they go on and on. Guess who sighs his lullabies through nights that never end? My fickle friend, the summer wind. Warm summer wind. Ah, the summer wind.
That's it. That's the story.
And this is a great song. This is called Nothing But the Best. And I wish that to you and everybody there, wherever you are, for this song.
I like the new Lincoln with all of its class. I like a martini and bird on the glass. I'm gonna start living. You wait and see. Nothing but the best is good enough for me. I like to eat lobster directly from Maine. I like to watch bullfights in sunny old Spain. I'm gonna start living. You wait and see. Nothing but the best is good enough for me. Tally ho, hey, off we go. Who can wait another day? You and me out on a spree. Hey, let's get started. Ooh, right away. We're gonna go traveling and have us a fling. We'll visit a palace and we'll dine with a king. I'm gonna start living. You wait and see. Nothing but the best is good enough for me.
So everybody, please, just follow what you love to do. Kind of simple. Move into the direction of what you want. And the world opens up to you.
You and me, out on a spree. Hey, let's get started. Ooh, right away. We're gonna go traveling and have us a fling. We're gonna visit a palace and we'll dine with a king. I'm gonna start living. You wait and see. Nothing but the best is good enough. Nothing but the best is good enough.
Harry.
Once again, thank you.
I want to thank you so much for coming on our show. That was powerful.
Thank you.
I mean, that was why I had to take your card, had to get in touch with you.
Thank you.
By the way, if someone wishes to get in contact with you, how should they go about doing it?
There's a website, russellandrusso.com.
Slowly.
Russell, R-U-S-S-E-L-L, and A-N-D, Russo, R-U-S-S-O.com.
Two more times.
Okay. That's russellandrusso.com. And we're going to go tour the country now. I have a great companion. We sing together and we do shows all over the country. So
now, getting back to things like that, there's another thing I would like the audience to know. If they wish to have a secret of how to develop into what they want to be, and they would like to read your book, what should they do?
Amazon.com, and it's available on a, you know, on the tablet, and there's a hard copy that you could purchase. But once again, I the book was written because I want people to be inspired to do what they love to do, and it's not too late. And don't overanalyze it. Follow your heart, but you got to do something.
You have to act.
Right. You know, you're praying to win the lottery, but you never buy a ticket.
But you also have to have a plan, a roadmap.
A roadmap. Get out there. You don't have to have exactly. You could correct yourself, but just get out there and let the world help you. Be your best friend. You know, take care of yourself and move in the direction of your dreams. And thank you once again.
And you were telling me that this is one of a series.
This book is a series from the co-author, Andrea Gigline, mm-hmm. Don't Die series of people who have her first book was Don't Die with Vacation Time on the books. You know, so too many people have vacation time and they're building it up and then an illness takes it and they never use it. So, the series is a very, I'm happy to be a part of it. And it's a simple read. There's a little worksheet and it's quotes in it and it's just an easy read. So, you know, follow what you love to do. That's all I have to say. Thank you.
Again, thank you so much for coming on my show.
Oh, it's a pleasure.
This is Speak Up. I am Sandra Schulte. Thank you so much for watching our show. Until the next time, have a wonderful rest of the day.